Righty. Hello everyone, and welcome back to another random YouTube video on Chris's channel. Today we're going to be looking at one of my favourite skirmishing guns. This is my first one of two, actually, because I like them that much. Tokyo Marui SOCOM M4s variant, of course, in the well-known SOP mod Gen 2, as they're known, AEGs. Quite interested in these when I first saw the SOP mod. Thought AEGs, good fun, but it'd be nice to have some of the features of a gas blowback rifle: recoil, bolt lock, C-swing firing, etc., etc. And when the SOCOM came out, so it's a lot cheaper than the SOP mod, I thought I'd go for one of them. So this is my first one, and I think what we're going to do is just run through a few of the features of how I've customized this to my own liking, as it were, what I've done, what I've changed to make it work for me at a skirmish game. Like, this is all personal preference, of course. Everyone has different needs, they play at different fields. Where you play is going to determine what sort of a weapon you're going to buy and how you're going to set it up. But like I say, this is just what I've done, and hopefully this will be slightly informative for some of you. We'll start from the back and work forward and go through all the different parts, what I've changed from the standard layout and the reasons why. In the very back, you've got the butt pad on the stock. This is pretty much just aesthetic. There's not really any kick that you need to absorb on an electric blowback. They don't have that much recoil. I just like the look of that. They're not very expensive. I'll throw it on there. Stock is the PTS version of the Magpul ACS stock. Now, the thing with the ACS stock is, in my opinion of it, it's pretty much the only thing it's got over the CTR or the MOE is the storage spaces. So if you don't want the storage spaces, which I personally didn't, I only went for this because I wanted the look of it for this particular rifle. It's got the friction lock there, the same as the CTR. So in terms of, it's very solid. I went in OD because I play in the woods, so I want green guns, green accessory for my guns. It's extremely solid. You get a good cheek weld on there, a bit like a crane stock, obviously. Got storage spaces on either side there for batteries and a generic space in there. That can be handy, but generally this particular stock, unless you specifically want that storage space, I would go with the CTR or the MO. They do the same job and they're cheaper. So yeah, but like I say, for the particular look of this rifle, I went with this, quite happy with it. My sling point here is the PTS, again, ASAP, for a gas blowback rifle. If any of you out there have got a SOP mod or a SOCOM and you want a 1-point sling hook to go on here, and you want an ASAP, then a good way, there are other versions out there which will fit. The problem with the PTS ones is, even if you buy the gas blowback, the inner diameter of the circle is slightly too narrow, so you're going to have to get a Dremel inside there and widen it out, and also take a bit of material off these small sort of wing portions, as it were, in order to get it to fit. Once this, mine's pretty solid on there, it's not wobbled. I've managed to, as long as you test and fit, it goes on pretty well, and it's an excellent sling point. It enables you, of course, as it's well known, to change your shoulders. Really good bit of kit. Moving forward, we'll go on to the pistol grip next. I've gone for the Myad, although my recent thinking is that I'm probably going to just buy the Mo grips in the future because they're cheaper, and I always go with this thicker backstrap rather than the thinner one that's supplied with, because I prefer that style of grip, which basically means that I'm paying more just to get something that's the exact same as a Mo grip. So that's what I'll be doing in the future. Important point to note, this is a very good tip I've found in my experience with these particular AEGs. Base plate, the plastic one that these PTS grips come with, it's no good, the motor won't quite sit right and the gun won't function. Get the upgraded metal base plate, solves that issue. Trigger guard, when you buy the Myad, it came with the BTS trigger guard, just installed that. It is better, it removes the annoying gap you sometimes get just up in here, which can sort of end up being fatiguing that part of your finger there. It can be quite painful after a while. Fills that in, don't have that issue anymore. Flipping it over, I've got the PTS bad lever for WE and PTW type rifles. Now this actually goes on with no problem, fits just fine, and it does work. So it's actually, for an AEG, it's quite a good upgrade. When you're firing, it goes to bolt lock, switch mags, hit that with your trigger finger, and you're back into action instead of having to slap it, which is a slight, you know, it doesn't increase your speed, just that little bit, and it looks quite cool, I think. Bearing in mind, I also tried the real steel, the actual Magpul Industries one on here, and because of the curvature of the arm part on there, it doesn't stick in allow the actual ping pong paddle, as Costa would call it, to stick out far enough, and the bolt lock will never function. You'll just carry on firing even with an empty mag in there. So another pointy note there. Moving up, obviously all the receivers standard because no one's bought an aftermarket one out yet. My backup iron sight is a GMP Troy style. That's pretty much for the book again, to be honest. I can't see me ever having to use them. It just looks nice. It completes the overall aesthetic of a rifle. I like it. They're really good quality backup sights. If you are looking for some Troy style backup irons to go on a rifle, highly recommend GMP, really well made. Optic, this is a bit of a random one, it's not particularly realistic looking. It's a star, not Aries, star, very old, 4x ACOG, not illuminated or anything fancy, just 4x zoom. And it's just simple, it works, it's got a nice clear set of lenses in it. I personally play in woodland fields and I like the ability, not just for aiming, it is for aiming, but I'm the main reason I like to have a zoom optic on there is for spotting enemies at a distance and identifying friend and foe, all that sort of side of things. Personally, my eyesight isn't all that great. I don't like wearing glasses under my airsoft eye protection. Tend to fog up, so stick my ACOG on there, and that's all sorted. Moving forward again, the handguard I've gone for is the King Arms copy of the Voltor CASV. Personally, I really like the look of it. The advantage is, of course, with the SOCOM, you are limited. You have to have a battery at the front here, so you are sort of limited to the handguard you can use. You can use, if you're using a very particular type of lipo, you can use pretty much any quadrail free float handguard that you fancy, but you'll probably have to remove the fuse, etc. It's a little bit more of a job. I didn't want to do all that. I just wanted to stick with my standard batteries, leave the fuse, etc. And that meant I needed a bit more room inside the handguard, so I've gone with this one. I'm pretty happy with it. It's got some nice trades on there. It's very solid. The paint, the chip's a bit easy, but like I say, I like the look of it. Came with flip up front sight as an option. You can attach rails wherever you want. I've just left it plain because I like how it looks and I didn't want any vertical grips or lasers, etc. on there. It's just a bit of a change really from the standard plastic handle. Got some ladder covers on top there just to protect the rails I'm not using. Inside the handguard, I've replaced the standard triangular sort of US general issue front sight post with a GMP, not sure if you can see it down there, Daniel Defense style low profile gas block. And I've still got the Tokyo Marui fake gas tube on the inside there, which I like the look of. It's nice to have. And right at the end, standard barrel right at the end, I've got a GMP Knights Armament style triple tap brake. It's quite a good replica, pretty well made. Well, I say it's quite a good replica. The actual number of slots They should go all the way around, of course. They don't on this particular replica, but it looks close enough. It's, like I say, it's well made. I'm pretty happy with it. On the inside, not changing much. I've left it in the stock FPS, and because of the hop unit Marillion uses in these guns, which is a rotary type, a bit like the old TM M14 line, which amazing hop unit, far better than the standard ones that you'll get in a normal AEG AR-50, any sort of M4, M16, etc. Those hop units, they're alright, but these that they put in here, by comparison, just a really leaps and bounds ahead. And therefore, I've left the FPS, so i.e. the spring, all the insides of the gearbox, all of that is completely stopped, because it's Tokyo Marui and I know it's just going to run and run for thousands and thousands and thousands of BBs. Because I'm happy with the range and accuracy it gets because of the really good hop unit, that's a combination that works. Even though I'm playing in woodlands, I've got my 14.5 inch outer barrel into which I've installed a Mad Bull Black Python range 6.03 in a barrel, got a 363mm length one in there. And even though this is clocking around 280 FPS, which is the stock for these things, the range is just as good as various guys out in the field that are shooting 350. Sometimes I get more range and better accuracy than those guys at much lower FPS, which to me is always a winner. So yeah, happy with that. And that is a brief overview of the rifle and why I've done it the way I've done it. This is obviously all these things, they're all down to personal choice. How do you want your gun? You know, a lot of people, they won't want zoom optics. They think that's not necessary for airsoft. Well, you know, up to you. I like to, my eyesight isn't that great. Like I say, I find it extremely handy for identifying enemy targets at longer distances when I'm playing in wood. But if you just want an EOTech on there, or an aim point, whatever, you crack on. A lot of people like shorter barrels nowadays. Personally, I play in the woods, I think, you know, 10.5 inch barrel stops about there, mine stops over there. Doesn't make that much of a difference. I'm not playing a CQB type game, so for the sort of skirmishing I do, this is what works for me, and hopefully some of you may go away from this and possibly have learned a little bit and think, well, maybe looking at that, I can possibly improve my gun for my style of play. But yet again, all down personal preference. And to finish off, we'll do a little bit of shooting. Maybe 10-15 meters away. Got a 8.4 volt battery in here, because in my experience, the trigger response on these things is that good. There's really no need for anything more. High pro, first and foremost. Most important thing in this sport, without a doubt. Bolt lock has even decided to behave itself today. Something my other SOCOM doesn't like to do. A bit of an issue. But yeah. Hope you all enjoyed watching. See you next time.